It's Christmas time. To celebrate, and because it's our 10th Christmas here at Arch, we're counting down the team's favourite Christmas toys and games they were dreaming that Santa would deliver them when they were 10 years old. So sit back, grab an eggnog, and chuckle heartedly at the downward spiral we've all been on since childhood. So to kickstart our countdown at number 15, we have Developer Matt's Tech Deck Skateboards. Skateboards you controlled using your hands. Matt assured us he'd never grow out of playing with toys. He hasn't. And at this stage, it's likely that he never will. Number 14 is Beanie Babies, which Gemma was apparently obsessed with as a child. And what a cutie she was. Apparently, some Beanie Babies are worth millions of pounds to collectors these days. Gemma doesn't have one of those, though, so she's here at Arch. In at number 13, we've got Pokemon cards from Joby. Nice skinhead, Joe. Pokemon is a reoccurring fad, a bit like Joe's beard. Don't worry, Joe, beards will get fashionable again soon. Razor for Christmas? What kid didn't want a BMX, right? At number 12, we have Project Manager Matt. ET's BMX could fly. All Matt's has done is gather dust, as the crushing weight of the real world leaves him little time for BMXing these days. Narrowly missing out on the top 10, in at number 11, is Sarah's Xbox 360. Look at that smile. That's right, Sarah was only 10 when the second generation console came out. If it's any consolation, it also means she lacked a fulfilling childhood of outdoor playing and vitamin D. Number 10 is Steve's Trionic Electronic Reconstruction Kit. Nice hair, Steve. Remember that? No. Steve built his own radio to stave off the crippling boredom that came in an era before television. Great job, Steve. You made it. At number 9, we've got Dan's robotic set. Yep, Dan was a bit of a dork when he was younger. How things have changed. But he'll have the last laugh when our robot overlords rule the roost. Ha 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 ha! Here's child prodigy Charlie with his Casio keyboard at number 8. Nice specs, Charlie. The only keyboard Charlie allegedly uses these days is the one connected to his Mac, which he uses every single working day of his life. Hey, Charlie! At number 7 is Rich's Thundercats Lion-O action figure. Edgy shirt, Rich. Rich admired Lion-O's physical prowess and athleticism, leading to a sedentary life as a desk-bound graphic designer. Oh, the irony. Number 6 is Darren's Rally Arena. Someone's mum had a pudding bowl. Ha ha! 10-year-old Darren liked nothing more than to cruise along, hair whipping in the wind, dressed in Lycra. He still enjoys Lycra today, but sadly, there's no hair for the wind to whip. For number 5, it's Tash's Barbie doll. Lovelier dress. Cardigan? Yeah. Barbies were Tash's thing. They were what gave her the staunch feminist views that she holds today. Down with the patriarchy. In at 4, Joe's choice was a toss-up between Action Man and He-Man. Is there a theme here, Joe? Anyway, by the power of Grayskull, Mattel's muscle-bound master of the universe, He-Man won the day, as he always did. Number 3 is Luke's Scalex trick. Don't forget the sun cream, Luke. Being a kid is never easy. Thankfully, everyone pretended to like young Luke, so they could play with this great toy. In at number 2 is April's quintessential future designer present, an Etch-A-Sketch. If you thought April's favourite present was boring and predictable, you'd be right. So here we go, it's Arch's favourite Christmas toy. At number 1, we've got Gav's favourite, Space Lego. Look at that smile. Young Gav seems to have nursed dreams of becoming an astronaut when he grew up. Instead, he's here at Arch. Don't worry, Gavin, there's still time. So there you have it, folks, a walk down memory lane and a heartwarming look into the childhoods of your favourite design agency. Happy 10th Christmas, Arch Creative, and Merry Christmas to everyone who took the time out of their busy schedules to watch this short, shameless promotion. Anyway, it's almost the last day of term, so we're off to play with our toys. Have a great new year, and see you in 2017.